you. So, is there anybody you've seen recently that you ran into that you were happy to see?
Mom.
Maybe somebody that you hadn't seen in a long time. No,
Postman!
Raise your hand. We're going to grill you. Raise your hand.
Middle school friend.
You saw a middle school friend? Mm-hmm. Okay. What was the middle school friend's name?
Marriage.
Jordan.
I had a little too drink.
Where did you run into each other?
We ran into each other here in D.C., but we knew each other in Belgium.
Like, where in D.C.?
At El Rey.
Okay, and you knew each other from Belgium. Did you study abroad, or like?
I was raised there.
You were raised in Belgium? Okay, and why was he here?
He and his family moved back to D.C. once, you know, you lose your job. my father lost his job.
I went to Europe for the first time in August. I studied French and Spanish in college, but I never studied abroad because my parents were like, we might get divorced. And I was like, cool. You're paying for everything, so I don't want to be like overseas. So I went to Europe for the first time this last summer to see the Harry Potter play, but also to go to Paris to meet a guy from Instagram. who I'd never met, and we went to Paris together.
How was he? You went on a date? I'm assuming you went all the way to Paris.
It was like a 4-day date in Paris. I location shared with like a bunch of people, I think, in case I had disappeared. And what's funny is he left early, because I was like, when we planned, I was like, you need to leave a little early, because like, I might hate you. So I planned like a day by myself to like go to museums and stuff. But it was the Ascension, some Catholic holiday to do with Mary. So everything was closed. So I went to the Centre Pompidou, which I wanted to go to for like half my life, and I got there and it was just like dark. So I wandered around Paris alone. I had the worst day because my Instagram like thirst trap had left me.
That reminds me of a time I was in Spain, because I studied abroad in Spain, and it was the day before I had to leave for the UK, and I was so broke, but I was like, I got this ticket, I'm gonna go to the UK, and I was in Sevilla, Spain in the summer, so it was like 110 degrees, and I was biking around because my hostel wasn't open, and I got there super early, and I biked around, and I lost my passport. I lost it on the ground, and then I told the people from the hostel, and they were like, oh, we'll help you find it. So I spent that entire day riding bikes around Sevilla looking for a passport on the ground that had most definitely been stolen. So if you ever go to Spain and you see somebody who is like, hey, I'm Bam Alston, they're not there.
Georgia.
After our dates lasted like a week now, I would have got that. But I really think we should end this date, Dredge. It's been a lot of time together.
I hear you. Okay, this is uncommon.
Yeah.
But I really feel like I'm calling for you. These last 5 days.
Well, what about the last two?
Well, I was thinking about you for 3 before that.
Oh my god. I think I could be falling for you too. But we need some space.
So you said you're falling for this girl? Tell me about her, son. What's her name?
George. No, she's so
Dredge.
She told you it's Dredge?
Yeah.
My beautiful baby.
She's as white as a lily. Her hair, she has golden locks. She kind of looks like a cyborg from the future, though. I'm gonna name her Dredge.
So this 4-day interview seems like a lot of work to work at Google. And it seems like you wouldn't be that physical, and like a job is mostly based on computers.
Oh. Our campus is really big. You need to have the ability to just like
get
sprints around it.
Are there buses that just like take you? Like the different
you've never seen your staff. Like, you
only senior staff at Google is allowed to ride the bus?
It's like the most expensive public private transit system.
No, just
you can't get up.
We need our staff to be as high performing as our platform.
I was up in 7 and 2 hours, okay, code.
There's a lot of chefs who code who are trying to work at Google, so you're gonna have to really prove yourself.
And he's closed! Like everything!
Even
his social public. The social public! Closed! I'm sorry, the wood. I'm new here. I don't know if that's like a y'all just nap. Y'all just nap in the middle of the day.
Lunch lasts like a few hours, and then you take a nap.
You
inhale
so much wine.
Yeah. Actually, I took my lunch like 3 days ago. I had no idea it was the Ascension of Mary. I came to the whole week because I thought it was Sunday.
Social clues that I should be laughing right now.
Yeah,
what?
Do you have to speak Flinch? Flinch.
No, I did not bring my wine in the fridge.
When they're adopted.
Exactly.
Which is also super important.
Yeah, and it's why they would never steal it.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. Oh man, she's rude.
She
yeah.
wrote a letter?
Oh man.
She's gonna have her address.
Guys.
Maybe return.
Welcome to day one of Montessori School. I'll be in the same room as you, since it's just...
It's just us!
Hey! Principal Rick, why don't you come over?
I'm a germaphobe. So I'm the plexiglass, but we're in the same room.
Dredd actually has a,
You'll have to speak up the plexiglass.
Dredd actually has a physical limitation, we were hoping to... Dredd? Pay attention. A physical limitation. She is android. She is half human and half robot.
That sounds less like a limitation and more like the opposite of that.
Revolves around Jesus.
I found a passport, man. We're gonna make so much money off of this, you can't even believe. It looks like, oh, there's a... A heartfelt note. Seems that. Oh my God. She's adopted and doesn't know. How do we? Do we return it at this point?
I thought we were just gonna use the money.
You were gonna use the money to get a job in Europe. It's very hard.
Get a trip to Europe. But I don't think I could go through with it now that I see this. We have to find him.
We have to find it, you're right. Or else we're never gonna get a trip to Europe.